And we begin with breaking news. Right now, we understand a Dallas ISD school bus has caught fire. You are taking a live look from HD Chopper 8 over LBJ and Forest. That is in Dallas. Right now, you can see the fire is out, but there is a whole lot of soot around that school bus. We understand firefighters, of course, are still on scene, and that bus was full of children, taking children home, presumably from school this afternoon. Here's some Twitter video that's popped up in the last couple of minutes of that bus when it was on fire. You can see a whole lot of smoke there in the sky. And we want to go right to Jobin Panicker, who is out there on the scene. He's got the very latest information. Jobin, what can you tell us right now?
Well, good afternoon. Yeah, you know, we just rolled up on this scene likely minutes before all of this happened. I'm going to step out of the way here. This school bus sat here right on 635 on the off ramp to Abrams. When we showed up, all we could see was a dark plume of smoke. And then as we got closer, keep in mind, this is sort of there is some, you know, people going home, so there's quite a bit of traffic. So as soon as we got closer, we started to see that it was a yellow bus, and obviously the concern there when you see that is children. What we know now, what we're being told, is there were no children on this bus. The bus driver is okay. We're being told by some witnesses that when they came up, they saw the bus driver trying to open up the front of the bus. I can only assume to keep the bus from overheating. Of course, now we've got a situation where DFR has had to respond, and they did take out the fire. It is still a charred. There's still some, obviously, a charred up bus, at least on the front half of it. I've got Keenan Poole here. Keenan's vehicle, you can't see it, but it's actually probably a quarter mile from here. You parked up. You were actually right behind this bus, right, when this happened. What did you see as you were pulling up?
Well, when I pulled up, I seen the bus on fire. It was just the front of the bus that was on fire at that point in time. And I pulled up, got out my car, and I ran up to the bus as fast as I could. At that point, the bus started having black smoke instead of white smoke. And so I opened the back of the bus.
You opened up the back?
Yes, I opened the back of the bus to see if there was anybody inside. And then there was a lady over here, I guess that was the driver of the bus, that was screaming that there was nobody in the bus. So I backed up from the bus. At that point in time, there was no first responders yet. So I backed up from the bus, and we just, at that point, waited until the first responders arrived, and they got here really quickly.
And so I can only imagine, as you're rolling up to it, there's some obvious concerns right off the bat, right? And that was your first concern?
My first concern was that there was children on the bus, that we needed to get somebody out of there, because there was no first responders yet. And you couldn't see, it was so smoky that you couldn't see whether there was somebody in the bus or not.
Obviously a scary situation. I can't imagine being this driver here. What could you hear from her? What did she say?
She was just waving her arms and screaming that there was nobody on the bus. And I couldn't hear her, obviously. The smoke and the fumes and the flames were real loud, so I couldn't hear anything, especially with the freeway being right here. And then I finally went over there to figure out what it was, and you know, she was over there telling us that there was nobody on the bus.
Thank you, Keenan Poole. Again, Keenan showed up on this scene just as it was happening here. They are putting some more water onto that bus, as you can imagine. They will for at least an hour or so. That's generally how this works. Thankfully, nobody was hurt. No kids were inside. It was just the bus driver. The bus driver is okay. We can actually see her from here, and she seems to be okay. Seems a little shaken up, but that kind of happens when you have such a traumatic thing like this happen. We're reporting live here in Dallas. Jobin Panicker, Channel 8 News.
Jobin, our thanks to you. I'm glad we've cleared up that no one was actually on that bus. That's not the information we initially got. So we will certainly bring you more about this developing situation as we get it.